Welcome to Houston Celebration. What a great day it is. We want to thank Joni and Marcus for this wonderful opportunity to come before you today. It is a wonderful day. It's a great day in Houston. It's a great day outside. And I'm reminded of what the psalmist said there in Psalms. It said, "This is the Lord's doing, and it's marvelous in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it." And that's good news for somebody, because you really do have something to rejoice about. Regardless of what life looks like today, you have something to rejoice about, because truly it's beautiful outside and the sky is blue. So that just simply lets us know that wherever you are, that there's a blue sky nearby that you can look out and look upon and see the beauty and the glory of God. Today is an awesome day. We have a great guest in the studio on today, Reverend Victor Barr, the pastor of Omega Gospel Ministries. We're poised for a great time on today. We want you to know that God has a blessing in store for you. All you have to do is to believe and ask. And also, we have prayer counselors available to connect with you. That prayer number is 281-212-1037. Call in, let them know what your request is, because we believe in prayer and we know what the prayers of the righteous can do. We also have a great guest in the audience on today, and they'll be singing for us, Omega Gospel Music Ministry. Please help me welcome them.
Together, let's praise the Lord, He's alive. Together, let's praise the Lord, He's alive. Everybody, praise the Lord, He's alive. Come on, let us praise the Lord, He's alive. Together,
let's praise the Lord, He's alive.
Together,
let's praise the Lord, He's alive. Together, let's praise the Lord, He's alive. Together, let's praise the Lord, He's alive.
Together, let's praise the Lord, He's alive. Together, let's praise the Lord, He's alive. Everybody, praise the Lord, He's alive. Come on, let us praise the Lord, He's alive. Oh, 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 oh,
oh, let's praise the Lord, He's alive.
Oh, oh, oh,
oh,
oh, oh, oh,
oh, let's praise the Lord, He's alive.
Mystica!
Woo!
Amen.
All I saw, when miracle,
up for Jesus.
Come on, come on.
Stand up for Jesus.
Sister, where are you? Oh,
stand up for Jesus.
Pastor Victor, where are you? Oh,
stand up for Jesus.
Omega, where are you? Oh,
stand up for Jesus.
Yesta, where are you? Oh,
stand up for Jesus.
Everybody, where are you? Oh,
stand up for Jesus.
We want to thank Omega Gospel Music Ministry for that wonderful song. And truly, Jesus sets us free. We know the Bible tells us you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. And once we know Jesus Christ, we are truly set free to rejoice, to praise, and to be thankful. I'm Arthur Johnson, and I am happy to be here with you on today, hosting Houston Celebration. I am the CEO of the Vision Inspired Performance Group and Executive Pastor of Deliverance Temple Ministries, where God is doing a great work and is allowing us to be a blessing to the body of Christ. But on today, we have a wonderful guest here with us on today, Pastor Victor Baugh of Omega Gospel Ministries.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Bless you. Welcome to Houston Celebration.
Thank you.
So we're glad to have you here on today. Amen. Tell our viewing audience a little bit about Omega Gospel Ministries.
Thank you very much. Before I talk to our audience about Omega, I just want to thank my cousin Johnny Lamb for this opportunity to be on this, and also to the general manager here in Houston, Mr. Naran Williams, who is going to be our guest for the program we have, and to you, Mr. Johnson, for being my host today. Yeah, my name is Pastor Victor Baugh, and I'm the senior pastor for Omega Gospel Ministries in Houston. And Omega Gospel Ministries is 5 years old today. By December, we will be celebrating our sixth anniversary.
Wonderful.
And the Lord has been so good to us, and it's been really great.
Good.
Thank you.
Wonderful. We're glad to hear that y'all have been in existence for 5 years, and God is truly blessing your efforts and continuing to bless your efforts.
Amen.
Now, Omega Gospel Ministries, what's at the heart of the ministry?
Amen. That's a key question that the ministry really have a base on the fact that our sole aim is to restore relationships and bring the saving knowledge of the Lord Jesus to our community. And before we came into our community was in a little chaos, a lot of quarrelness, got a lot of problems here and there, and people were always living in, you know, disagreement with one another. But the Lord, when Omega came into town, we began to preach the gospel of love, the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, and many people began to give their lives to the Lord. And our community began to come together again, so there is love now in the community, there is peace, people are happy again with one another, and it's been a great soul winning process so far.
Wonderful. That is exciting to hear, because truly we know that when the Spirit of God is in the midst, Amen. That there truly can be no confusion, because he says he's not the author of confusion.
Amen.
And if we put him in the middle of whatever the situation is, whatever the circumstance is, right. He will definitely bring it all together. So it's good to hear that Omega has come to the community and has had an impact Amen. In the community by sharing the very love of God. Mm. Because we know that it's the love of God that draws and compels men to come.
Right.
And as I like to say, if we have the vertical relationship right, the horizontal has to be right.
Amen.
So if we have our relationship with God and Jesus Christ right, and allow the Holy Spirit to flow through us, we can then get along with our brothers and our sisters, and we can have that community that God expects us to have.
Amen.
So when you look at Omega Gospel Ministries and you're there impacting the community, there are different nationalities that are part of your ministry, right?
Oh, yes. And that is why we're having this International Day celebration, Stroke Gospel Festival, Gospel Musical Festival. The International Day is just a time we want to bring to the acknowledgement of the fact that no matter what background we come from, we can all worship together.
Yes.
You know, we are all one in Christ. We believe in the same Lord Jesus Christ. I don't care what country in the world you come from. We are all aiming for the same goal, which is heaven. And so we just want to celebrate the goodness of the Lord with the many nations that the Lord has blessed us in our church. We have people from Malawi in Africa in our church. You know, one of the things I discover about we are African descents who are here, everybody thinks that every African you see is from Nigeria. Uh-huh. But I want to say that we're not from Nigeria. I'm from Cameroon. Okay. It's a neighboring country to Nigeria. And we have people from Congo in church, from South Africa, from Malawi, from St. Lucia, and many other countries from the United States. Mm. You know, so the musical festival is a way we want to bring other choirs from other churches. Mm-hmm. To come together so that we can worship in different languages. Yes. We're going to have Spanish choirs. Mm-hmm. They're going to come. The Spanish choir of the Restoration Chapel will be coming with us. Okay. Other choirs will be coming. And we have choirs from African descents that will be coming to sing in African languages. Okay. But all of this, the joy of this is that all of this is to praise the Lord. As we all know in Psalms 117, verse 1 and 2, the Bible says, let all the nations worship the Lord.
Yes.
And it's a time we just want to come together as different people from different nations in the world, but having one common goal, which is to worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Amen.
Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen. That is so good to hear that you can bring all nationalities together, because truly that's the way it's going to be in heaven.
Amen.
It's not going to be this nationality, that nationality, so forth and so on.
Right.
We're going to all be giving praises unto our Savior and our loving God.
Amen.
And if you're watching on today and you feel that you have perhaps done something that maybe you seem to be so different from somebody else, well, there's a loving God who loves you just like you are.
Amen.
No matter what situation you've gone through, no matter what struggle you're struggling with, you can come to God by way of Jesus Christ. And then you can have this celebration that we're talking about, praising the Lord, giving thanks to your Savior. So if you need someone to talk to, if you need someone to pray for you, call the prayer line. We have prayer warriors waiting to hear from you. 281-212-1037. 281-212-1037. And know that there is nothing too hard for God.
Amen.
So there's
just catching with you on that, the Bible says in Acts 16:16,
yes,
that when Paul and Silas were shut up in a prison jail,
yes,
you see, what brought them out of that jail was praise and worship.
Mm, yes.
The Bible says they went into the presence of the Lord in praise and worship,
yes,
such that there was an earthquake. The Bible says the foundations of the prison shook.
Sure.
To say that I don't know what prisons you are finding yourself inside. Maybe a prison of financial troubles.
Mm.
Maybe a prison of some marital trouble. Whatever it may be your prison. Yeah. I just want to assure you that as you come for us to worship him.
Yes.
And maybe you've been praying for so long a time. But I want to ask you to do one more thing. Worship him.
Mm.
You know, worship is that thing that when you come into his presence in worship,
yes,
you are saying that, God, no matter what, you are still my king.
Yes.
And you are telling him that. You're just like the three Hebrew children who said, hey, we are not ready to bow to your God.
Right. Right.
Even if our God is not able to deliver us, we will not worship your king, your God.
Yes.
So when you come to the Lord in worship, you are telling the Lord that you are all and all in my life. In fact, I come from an African descent whereby I come from the palace.
Okay.
A palace is where there is a king and there is the subjects that worship him.
Yes.
And I discovered that while growing up in the palace, no matter who comes to the palace, whether you came to lay a complaint, whether you came to rejoice with the king, the first thing you do when you enter his presence is that you clap your hands and you bow down.
Mm.
So it doesn't matter how you came, it doesn't matter what grievances you came with, the first thing is that you bow down and you worship the king.
Yes.
So I got that when I began to relate with the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
That he is the king of every other king. Therefore, if you come into his presence, whether with a burden, whether with an answered prayer, whether with whatever circumstances, in worship, you are enthroning him Lord over every situation.
Yes.
And he will come through for you.
Yes.
Amen. The Bible says the three Hebrew children had that type of an encounter, and when they refused to worship the gods of this world, God came through for them.
Mm.
In Acts chapter 16, verse 16, the Bible said the prison doors were wide open when they worship and praise the Lord.
Yes.
So I just want to invite you, come from all nationals, from all tribes, from all colors. The Bible says in Revelation 7, 7 to 11 that is how we all will appear before the throne of God.
Right.
Every color, every national, every language, we shall all be in front of the King of Kings,
yes,
to worship him.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, beloved, we're just inviting you to come out, let's worship him. And I bet you, that situation in your life that you've been praying and maybe you feel like God has not heard you, come worship him and see what he's going to do for you. Amen.
Amen.
I strongly
Amen.
Believe at the end of that worship service, Saturday and Sunday, you are going to come out of there with your breakthrough. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. That is so good to hear, because we know worship definitely changes the atmosphere. And
Amen.
As you give the example of going before the king and they have to clap and they
right.
have to worship,
mm.
they're knowing that the king has the power
oh, yes.
and the ability to bring remedy to their situation. So I'm reminded in the Bible of the woman who was seeking justice, and she kept going to the judge, and she kept going to the judge, and she kept going to the judge. And the judge said, he was unjust judge,
mm-hmm.
and he said, let me give this woman what she wants
right.
before she wears me out.
Right.
So no matter what the situation is, as long as we're continuing to be persistent, knowing that the Lord hears our prayers, knowing that he hears our pleas, knowing that the fervent prayers of the righteous availeth much,
Amen.
That we will get that breakthrough.
Amen.
And
Amen.
I'm firmly believing as individuals come out on tomorrow
Amen.
To this international celebration, that they'll get exactly what they're expecting.
Amen.
Because
Amen.
Expectation brings about what we receive.
Oh, yes. And it all begins with our relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible says in John 1, verse 12, that as many as receive him, he gave them the power to be called sons and daughters of God, or children of God. I want to let you know that you are a child of God.
Mm-hmm.
And being a child of God is an open door for you to receive anything that you want.
Yes.
Therefore, as we all come and worship him, we are proclaiming his goodness in our lives.
Yes.
And beloved, even if you are watching and you don't know what it means to be a child of God, hey, I want to assure you that you can pray a simple prayer by just asking the Lord to come into your life.
Yes.
And when you pray that prayer, it's simply an acknowledgement that Jesus is Lord over your life. When you acknowledge him, he comes into your life, he becomes Lord over your life. And the Bible says in Psalm 139 and verse 13, it says, you are fearfully and wonderfully made.
Yes.
You know, when you begin to look into that word, fearfully and wonderfully made, it means that we are the wonders of God.
Yes.
When you pass, people see the glory of God upon your life.
Yes.
When you move and pass, the Bible says we marvel at his creation.
Mm.
And we are his creation.
Yes.
Therefore, when we pass, people marvel at us. And that is to say that we only need to go back to the King of Kings,
yes,
the Lord of Lords, who created us and gave us this beauty, and worship him.
Yes.
I don't know how you, what situation you find yourself in, but I want to assure you that you are a child of God as you accept the Lord Jesus in your life. You know, I used to let my congregation know that God created everybody in this world, but not everybody is a child of God.
Yes.
You only become a child of God when John 1:12 becomes true in your life. He says when you accept him,
mm-hmm,
he makes you a child of God.
Yes.
And there is that room today for you to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Even as we talk, there is a number on the screen that you can call, and there will be somebody that will talk to you and lead you to the saving Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Wonderful words ministering to those who are listening on today.
Oh, yes.
And it's definitely our prayer that someone would receive that word that you spoke, because definitely it's the relationship, the saving grace of God that makes it all possible.
Hallelujah.
And we definitely have prayer counselors here that are available to do just that, to lead
Amen.
Them to Christ, to let them know that
Amen.
They can transcend their situation.
Amen.
Well, once again, we're definitely excited about Omega Gospel Ministries and all that's going on in the community.
Right.
And we definitely want you all to continue to allow the power of God to be expressed through the ministry. Do you have any future endeavors on the horizon for Omega Gospel Missions?
Oh, yeah. Before I talk on that,
sure,
let me just say that our program tomorrow and Sunday is going to be filled with the glory of the Lord. I just pray that when you come there, come with an open heart.
Mm-hmm.
We have a dynamic man of God that is going to be ministering on Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
The service will begin at 11 a.m.
Okay.
and we're pushing it to 11 so that we can give room for those from other churches to have time to join us. We have Mr. Nathan Williams, who will be our guest speaker. He's a dynamic man of God. I have heard him speak. And the good thing is that he's the manager of this station, so I'm so glad to have the manager of this station come and just minister and bless the people of God. So please, our services are going to be tomorrow, Saturday, is going to be from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. in the evening, and on Sunday morning from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Okay. So concerning what you just asked, we're looking forward to celebrate our sixth anniversary. And we don't take this lightly. We know that God has positioned us in our community at such a point in time as this for a particular reason. And there is still a lot to be done. And in spite of what we've achieved, we still pray endlessly that God will touch our people. Because one of the things we've discovered is that our people come into this blessed nation, and every one blessed thing they do is to run after the dollars and forget the God of the dollars, you know. And I always preach and illustrate that. I said, behind the dollar say, in God we trust.
Right.
Therefore, even as we come here, knowing that we have a burden of a lot of families back home that look on us, we should not forget the God that gave us the strength to make the wealth. So I just want to appeal to our community. Give God a chance in your life. Come to Him. At least set a time on Sundays to go to church, worship Him, and look a born-again church, a God-believing church, a church that the Lord is worshiping truth and in spirit, and worship Him and thank Him for giving you the privilege to be in this country. And with that, I just know that we are going to go somewhere. We can't come to a nation like this, and we know that the prosperity that God has bestowed upon this nation has come because of their fear for God. And I believe that we have to learn from that. When we look down in other countries in the world, we see that any country that abuses the grace that God gives them runs into chaos, into poverty, into problems. You know, so I just want to advise our community people, while we celebrate the goodness of the Lord in this country, let's give God a chance in our life by accepting Him into our lives as our Lord and Savior. And as I know, as we speak, people are calling. And we're going to be praying with you today. And and we hope that you'll make it for the program tomorrow and on Sunday. Amen. And amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Well, definitely we are winding down, and we've received several prayer requests.
Amen.
So definitely the word of God has gone forth, and it has ministered to our viewing audience.
Amen.
So we definitely want to take time to pray for these individuals that have called in, believing that God will answer their prayer.
Amen.
Because we know that prayer works.
Oh,
and
yes.
We know that the fervent
it
prayers of the righteous availeth much. And it's just interesting to hear you talk about the individuals that have come to America, and you not wanting them to forget about the God that made it possible. And we know that in Deuteronomy, we are encouraged and told to remember the Lord your God, for it is He that gives you power
to
get well. So we can't forget the source of the wealth. We can't forget the source of our abilities. We can't forget the one who made it all possible.
Hallelujah.
Because without Him, there's nothing that we can do.
That's true.
Amen.
That's true.
So let us join hands and just take time to pray over these prayer requests, knowing that God hears prayers and that God will answer prayer.
King of glory, we thank you. We acknowledge that you are God. And Father, your people have called, and your people are watching.
Yes,
Lord. My Lord and my God, we ask that as many that have called, that whatever is the situation of their lives, King of glory, they have called to the King of Kings, not to us. Therefore, Lord, we pray that you arise with healing in your wings and touch every one of them that is suffering of whatever sickness, whatever disease, whatever family problem, whatever marriage.
You are worthy.